All right, just want to do a quick little video here on Raw XXX. Retarded ass name for a show, by the way. And you might say, well, Ruthless Rant, are you in a bad lighting setting right now? Sorry, people, I actually work for a living, so I don't have time to sit on my ass and watch 3 hours of Raw. So I just wanted to get this video up, people. I'm not like the losers that watch wrestling on a consistent basis. I took about 10 minutes watching some YouTube segments. Just want to get my thoughts on why this episode sucked. It was overhyped. Of course, I was hearing about it a little bit, even though I don't watch this company anymore. You know, seeing shit on Twitter, seeing shit wherever I go on my phone. You know, I'm still in touch a little bit, you know. But so I thought, you know, there might be some good things on here, but turned out, nah. So here I am in my fucking car, just doing a little review here. And you're going to have to put up with some shitty quality. It's all good, people. First off, I took down some notes here. And you may say, well, Ruthless Rant, you're being negative, blah, 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 blah. That's in my YouTube name, people. Sorry, I fucking hate wrestling. I watched it for a long time. Now I fucking hate it because I realize how much it sucks. And how much I wasted my time back in the day. Maybe if I grew up in the Attitude Era or the Ruthless Aggression Era, I would think differently. First off, the name of the show. Why are you naming it XXX? That's named after a porno. I mean, what the fuck we doing here? You know? Second thing I got on my list. Hulk Hogan starts off the show, does a generic ass fucking promo, and the mic doesn't even work. Now, I'm actually gonna be nice, people. WWE has great fucking production. You know, that's one thing you gotta give them credit for. Cool entrances, cool special effects. So, you know, I'm gonna give them a pass here, but still I gotta mention that. The mic, just not a great, not a good look though. And yeah, he comes out here and does a generic ass promo, you know, doesn't even do anything. Like, again, nothing entertaining. The one great thing on this show was the Roman Reigns segment. Holy fucking shit. Look at what happens when you try to invest in a person that is not 20 years past their prime. It actually works out for you. You know, that was the only great thing on this episode, to be quite frank, is the Roman Reigns angle. I mean, that was just fucking great, people. And by the way, what they've been doing with Sami Zayn, and what they've been doing with Roman Reigns and the whole Bloodline storyline, it's fucking amazing. It's great. It's a diamond in the fucking shit. It's the only good thing on this show full of bullshit. Why? Because instead of being a one-time good thing, like seeing a fucking return from an Attitude Era star that's washed up, which is kind of a cool moment. Instead of seeing one cool moment like Stone Cold Steve Austin wrestling at WrestleMania or a return or something like that, actually investing in the stars of today's age that are actually in their prime creates not only good content for 1 week, it creates good content for months. And that's what they've been doing here. So great segment with the Roman Reigns thing. Only good shit to say. Then we get Undertaker returning to confront some jobber that I'd never heard of. Which I don't have a problem with him being a jobber. But I do have a problem with them bringing back the biker taker gimmick. I mean, I'm not going to, you know, get too into it. But the Undertaker gimmick is one of the greatest gimmicks of all time. Stick with it. I get they're trying to humanize the Undertaker because he's retired now. And, you know, we want to see the human aspect of it, and kayfabe is dead, and you know, but I would still love to see the Undertaker maintain. I get he's retired, so I don't expect the same kayfabe that we had 10 or 20 years ago with the Undertaker gimmick, but I would like to see some aspect of resemblance of that. And the Undertaker gimmick, I think most wrestling, if not all wrestling fans, can agree the Dead Man Undertaker gimmick is much better than the Biker Undertaker gimmick. So I would prefer him to be in classic Undertaker mode, not riding a fucking motorcycle. But it was cool to see him, I guess. I mean, I get Undertaker's old, but he could have at least given him a chokeslam, right? I mean, he didn't, not like he was out there on fucking crutches, but, you know, it would have been cool to see him give the person a chokeslam at least, but no, we didn't see that. Still cool to see Undertaker back, though, I guess. But, I you know, I'm ranting because that's in my name, people. Then we got another fucking DX reunion. I mean, I get it. DX did some great things back in the day, but every time we have a Raw reunion show or whatever the fuck, it's a DX, the same old ass DX reunion. And for some fucking reason, they stick Kurt Angle in there. Like, Kurt doesn't deserve his own segment. He got to be a little side. I mean, Kurt Angle, one of the greatest fucking wrestlers of all time, just gets thrown into a segment with DX. He could have had his own segment, but nah. You disrespect the legend. Just like you had him job out to Baron fucking Corbin for his last match. You couldn't even give him dignity. This guy has a fucking broken neck like 5 million times. You can't give him a good last match. You got to have him job out to Baron Corbin. I don't have anything against him, but... I mean, Baron Corbin of all people for a last match, come on. But to have Kurt Angle just kind of thrown in there like a sideshow, I didn't like. And we see these DX reunions time and time and time again. And it just gets old. Like, how many of them are you going to have? I mean, it's watered down at this point, and it's just not the best. You also had Brock Lesnar return, which, cool, I love Brock, but it's Brock. Not very versatile. Does the same shit every time he's out there. Again, I like him, but... he's not very versatile. When he was a heel, it was Suplex City. And that was it. Now, he's a babyface, and it was entertaining for a little bit. You know, because it was a new gimmick, and it was something new, and it was refreshing. But it's like he comes out, does a couple suplexes and F5, and that's it. You had a Divas steel cage match. I mean, here we go again with the Divas. They want to be just like men. They want to act like men. I'm a man. I'm Becky Lynch. I'm a man. I got a dick. Shut the fuck up. I mean, I'm so sick of them trying to, emulate the Divas, trying to emulate everything the men does. Like, oh, we got to have a steel cage match because we're women. We got to have all the special matches just because we're women, just sick of the Divas wrestling in general. Sick of Divas wrestling being pushed on us. Because men are equal to women. Women are equal to men. No, they're not. Not when it comes to sports, people. Men are better than women in physicality. Sorry, facts, people. They hurt, but it's true. Lastly, I'm going to talk about they had Ric Flair come out and introduce his daughter. One of the greatest wrestlers of all time coming out. And that's all he does is introduce his daughter. I mean, I thought they could have done more with him. But, hey, it is what it is, people. So, this Raw reunion show I did not like. They did not use these legends that great. I'm all for using... I do rant on part-timers a lot. But only in the sense that they use them as main parts of the show. I don't have a problem with them bringing back a part-timer... featuring them in a segment. But it can't be all or nothing. You can't bring back all these washed up Attitude Era / Ruthless Aggression stars, put them in top spots, and take away from the upcoming talent. That's wrong. But it's also wrong to bring somebody back for one show and feature them in like a 1 minute backstage promo or a 2 minute promo to open the show. Like, find the fucking middle ground. So there you go, people. Hey, maybe I'm fucking wrong about this. I don't fucking know. But I spent about 10 minutes watching shit on YouTube. And I'm here to give my thoughts. Sorry, not wasting my time like I did in the past. Melting away my brain cells watching this shit. So let me know what you thought about it in the comments below. Again, who knows? Maybe I'm fucking wrong. Maybe I missed some shit. But I don't think so, people. I don't make mistakes that often. So like I said, let me know what you think about Raw, Triple X. I logged on to Pornhub and I thought I would find this episode with it being named Raw Triple X, but it wasn't on there. But there you go, people. There's my thoughts on this episode.